ei rupe brahmanna bhramite kono bhagwan ji. Under this avidya karma sangha, titiya shakti, material energy, we are wandering throughout the whole universe. This child should be So, ei rupe brahmanna bhramite kono bhagwan ji. So, one who takes Krishna consciousness, bhagwan ji, not the dudbhagwan ji, mandasmanda matayu mandabhagya, those who are unfortunate, they cannot take to Krishna consciousness. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Pono bhagwan ji. Pono means somebody. That is also not all. That is confirmed by Krishna. Manushanam sahasresu kaschidyatati siddha. Out of many, many millions of persons, one wants to become perfect or bhagavan. And jatatama visiddhyanam kaschid vettimam tattva. So, therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also says the same thing. Kono bhagavane ji. Not always. Not the mandabhagya. So bhagavan. Ei rupe brahmanda bhamite kono bhagavane ji. Guru Krishna kripa pai bhakti lata bij. Guru and Krishna. Two persons favor. Guru and Krishna. So Krishna is asking to become a guru, everyone. Everyone become a guru. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says. Amar adgai guru haiya, taro ei desh, jare dakho tare kaha Krishna upadesh. Amar adgai guru haiya. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Mahavadana avatar, most magnificent incarnation to reclaim all the fallen souls, ei rupe brahmanna bhramite kono bhagavanji. So, the guru's business is to make everyone a bhagavan, fortunate. That is Guru's business. The Guru's business is that form of sympathetic, that one can give Krishna consciousness if he is fortunate. The Guru's labor, Guru's activities is how to make people fortunate. That is what. Because without being fortunate, one cannot understand Krishna. And without Krishna consciousness, he cannot be relieved from this avidya karma sangha shakti, material nature. Therefore, it is the business of Guru to make everyone fortunate. So, how we can make everyone fortunate? That is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu advises that amar agnaya guru hoy. You follow the principles of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's instruction, first of all. Śrī Kṛṣṇa Chaitanya Prabhu Nityānanda, Śrī Advaita Gadādhara Śivāśādi Gaura. You just take their mercy, then you become guru. And then what is your business? If the business is jare dakho tare kaho Krishna madhu. So, then Guru Krishna, Guru makes the people fortunate, and then the people become Krishna conscious. And then he becomes fortunate. This is the process of Krishna consciousness movement. Everyone is advised to become guru, especially those who are born in India. They can easily take the Krishna consciousness movement because in the blood there is Krishna consciousness on account of taking birth in this holy land of Bharatvarsha. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu therefore says, Bharat bhumite manusya janma haila ja. Janma sarthakari karo paropata. This is the business. So, every Indian is expected to take this Krishna consciousness movement and spread it outside India. There are many people who are hankering after it. It is the duty of every Indian to, first of all, get himself out of this clutches of avidya karma sangha. Ignorance and whole day and night working like hogs and dogs, one has to become free from this clutches of maya then he must undergo tapasya. There is no difficulty. This tapasya is that we have to give up the four principles: no illicit sex, no meat eating, no intoxication, no gambling. This is tapasya. It is not that you have to go to the forest or Himalayan mountain and enter into a cave and press your nose and no, that is not possible. You simply practice wherever you are. You simply practice this tapasya. No illicit sex, no intoxication, no gambling, and no meeting. Then you become perfect. Tapo dibbam putraka jina suddheta satya. This tapasya, can we do that? We can do it very easily. It is not said no sex, but no illicit sex. That is very simple. Therefore, one has to get himself married. That is allowed, but no illicit sex. No meat eating. Why one should eat meat? There are so many nice things given by Krishna. So many fruits, so many nice food grains. We can eat many palatable dishes mixed with milk. Take milk from the cows. Therefore Krishna advises, go raksha. Without milk, you will eat all rubbish things like hogs and dogs, and your life will be spoiled. Everything is there, practical. But our avidya, on account of our ignorance, foolishness, rascalna, we are avoiding